many circumstances to make a cup of tea. Have you ever thought while making tea, how many circumstances must have been working behind making a cup of tea? Will the work succeed if one of the evidences were missing? Say if you ran out of tea bags, but all the shops were closed because of public holiday. Or say the delivery trucks were on strike. Or if you run out of gas in your cooking stove. Besides these, say you had no water or no cooking stove. You even need a match or a lighter to light the stove. Would you be able to make a cup of tea if you did not have a lighter? And don't you need someone to drink the tea also? On top of that, you even need time to drink the tea. Do you ever get up at 2 in the morning and make a cup of tea? So many circumstances come together in even just making a cup of tea. And yet human beings take all the credit. I made the tea, they claim. But if the teapot or the gas cylinder, tea bags, milk, sugar, lighter, etc. were living, they too would want to take credit for it.
Hey, without me, how can you drink tea?
Hey, go away! Tea was made by me!
Hey, you saw that? I made such a good tea.
Oh, no, no. No one can make tea without me.
I don't make the tea!
No, no. The tea has been made by me.
So let's look at the truth and decide.
So, this lady who said she makes good coffee is my wife.
Okay.
I don't drink coffee at all.
You don't drink coffee at all. Okay. Not drinking coffee is also action. Inaction is also action. Okay, so is it clear who makes a cup of coffee?
I makes the coffee.
Yeah, it is actually the whole universe has to participate in your single action. That's why every single action of yours is God's action. Can you live your life throughout your life with the understanding that everything is God's will? Every action of mine is God's action. Every thought of mine thought is God action. Every work of mine is God's action. Then you'll be completely free from karma. Okay? That is the meaning of shloka Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharmam parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishami mahasya. Give the attitude of doership, ownership and enjoyership. God alone is the doer, God alone is the enjoyer, God alone is the thinker, God alone is the reality. This body, mind and intellect is just an instrument of the divine will. If you live with this attitude, no karma will touch you. That is called mukti. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
What is karma, I'll tell you. In a bank, there's a cashier. Okay? Daily crores of rupees come to the cashier. He counts the crores of rupee. One day, he thinks, I am counting any crores of rupee. Why not put 5 rupees in my pocket? So what will happen to the cashier?
Job loss,
jail. Right? Why? The money didn't belong to him. Did the money belong to the bank?
No.
It is a customer's money. You cannot take that money as yours. Similarly, everything in the world, every single thought, every single action, every object in the world is divine. The moment you take something and say, mine, you get into karma. That's the job, that's what happens to cashier. Karma is that. Saying that I did it, when the universe participated through you and made it happen, you say, take the responsibility. After the action has happened, that is called karma. And that what binds you. If you live with the attitude that everything is divine action, then you are free. Are you clear? So, let us end with a prayer.
Sir, I can have a question and answers.
No. This this question. This prayer is different prayer. Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
you are the one,
you are the one
who sees through my eyes,
who hears
through my ears,
who talks
through my tongue,
who acts
through my body,
who thinks
through my brain. I surrender. Thinkership, doership, enjoyership
to
thee.
May thy will be done
through this body, mind. If you live with this attitude, you will be free from karma. Suffering comes, then you say it's God's will. Joy comes, you say God's will. Okay? But if choose, then you got it your will. Then you got it karma. You have to have a choice, less life. That's called Daitya. Okay? So with that, I'll conclude the lecture. And it's open for questions for 5-10 minutes. Yes, sir.
Then what about the right and the wrong?
See, the right question, the right and wrong are there from two points of view. Two points, okay? It's okay. Question is, he's asking the question, what is right and what is wrong?
Right? What is right, what is wrong, and
yeah.
What is
dharma, what is yeah, what is dharma, what is adharma, what is right and wrong, we'll, I'll explain that, alright? So, I have told you, attitude we have to take in our life, how we do act, okay? Now his question is, what is right and wrong, what is dharma and adharma? So, you have a will, I mean, you want to have a desire to do something. And the desire harms somebody in the society, causes problem, hurts somebody, right? This society is also God's will. Then deep inside your conscience says, don't do that. So if you still did that, thinking it's God's will, then the punishment will come to you. That also will accept as God's will. If you listen to the conscience again, voice of God, you will not do that. The right and wrong is already known to you internally because God is in your heart. So then the moment you do ignore that and do something, that means you have brought human will. Then you fall into karma. Did you get it?
No, when you say right and wrong, first it should be careful whether it hurts
me
or not.
No, no.
I'm not bothered about your society.
No, no. Whether it hurts you, see, very simple. That's what is called dharma, okay? What is right and wrong, we know instinctively. I'm not speaking of, you don't have to learn in some school. Do you like somebody coming and hitting you? It's pains. Do you like somebody doing a pickpocket of your money? Right? So instinctively you know what is right and wrong for me. I should apply the same right and wrong for this society. This is called dharma. Dharma is not learned from these books. Dharma is your instinctive knowledge. I don't like anybody to kill me, I won't kill anybody. Right and wrong is actually instinctively there in your heart.
See, there are so many dharmas. It says, one dharma,
it says, one. No, that's not dharma. Sorry. See, you are speaking of religion. Religion and dharma are not same. See, in dharma, what you say in India, Sanatan dharma or Hindu dharma, is universal in nature. It has nothing to do with religion. You are speaking of religion. Religion is man-made. Dharma is not man-made. Dharma is God-made. The God-made, God doesn't give, have to give a book to you to know how to, what is dharma. Religion requires a book. God's, you know very well that I don't like somebody killing me and you instinctively know I don't want to kill anybody. That's called dharma. That is called Sanatana dharma. Dharma and religion are not same. Don't mix up dharma and religion. Dharma is universal and dharma need not be learned from books. Okay, dharma is your inborn knowledge.
No, supposing somebody has 5 wives, how he is hurting society?
No, what I am saying, that is actually how he is hurting society, how he is not hurting society. Who will decide? Who will decide? The societal system will decide. The society as a collective whole will say, this is right, this is wrong. That's the collective wisdom of the society, right? You should not go on the left side of the road. If society decides through us, so the society is also God. That has decided. It's right or wrong. In one society something may be right and another society something may be wrong. But that decision is not individual decision. It's not your inner power decision. That's a societal collective decision. The society is also God. When your conscience is God, that's also God. Right? So don't remove God out of the equation. The God operates as the laws of the society. That's why Sri Krishna says, Yada yada hi dharma se glani bhavati bhata. This dharma is, when the dharma vanishes in the society, as a societal practice, then he will come. So that is the...
What is that dharma? What is the commandments?
No. See, the commandments is different from dharma. Please understand dharma. Dharma is a very unique principle that I can take another class. What is dharma, what is commandment, what is religion, they are mixed up. That's a different class and that takes a long time. Dharma is very simply, you understand what you should not do to others, what you don't want to do yourself, you should not do others. Dharma is already told by God to you. Nobody has to give commandments to that.
Give some examples.
I will come and slap you. Do you like it?
Huh?
I will come and slap you. Do you like it? So you should not slap me. That's dharma. No novel has to write this. Right? You know it. Okay? I should not hurt you. You should not hurt me. This is written by who? Already written by you, God in your consciousness. That's not conscience. Dharma is given by God directly to you. Dharma doesn't require any books. If it requires books, it's made man-made.
It's a natural balance.
Natural balance. A tiger will eat one deer, it will not touch the second deer. Because tiger knows that if I eat second deer, our forest will be depleted. That is inborn in every living being. That's called God. Whereas man-made dharmas are there. Man-made, it's not dharma actually. It's religion, law, and all those things are there. That's a different topic. Okay. Yes, sir. Any next question?
Sorry, asking a personal question. Recently resigned from Mahindra Infotech.
Okay.
From a very top level, and switched over to spiritual side.
Hmm.
Was it your will, thy will, or both will? What do you really?
So far what I have told, from what I have told, what do you think it is? Very simple. If you regret for that, then your will has come. I mean, I'm saying the consequences you accept as thy will, it's thy will only. It's actually thy will, but it has happened to you.
Sir,
I also come from my mind.
This line of thought, from my will of free will to thy will to destiny, is fine. But it makes an individual redundant. And also, his existence itself is meaningless.
No. See, it's all ultimately your choice, okay? I'm not saying you choose this thought or that.
What I mean to say is that if we follow this line of thought, it looks like that an individual becomes redundant. And his very existence is meaningless.
Okay, so you are right about that. Right. But did I logically anything I did wrong in proving this line of thought?
No,
it's perfectly logical, right?
Yes, I accept that.
Okay, that's why he said, sir. In Sanatana Dharma, everything is Maya. It's a dream-like situation. Even though it's thy will, we believe it's my will and live. And once the reality dawns on you that this is not my will, this is thy will, then you are already close to Mukti liberation. This is the entire teaching of Sanatana Dharma. Understand? The Maya means appear, it's not reality. All our life, we are conditioned to believe that appearance is reality, but reality is different from appearance. In reality, individuals don't matter. That's why Sri Krishna said to Arjuna, Nimitta Matram Bhava Sami Sati, you are just the instrument. Everything is happening. But you are free to choose. Okay, I'm not saying you choose this line of thought. You are free to choose, everything is thy will or everything my will. Everything has a consequence of choosing.
Sir, is it near to Advaita philosophy? What you have
told,
sir?
It's Advaita. But see, I didn't bring any philosophy here. Did I do anything philosophy? It's pure logic and scientific experience. Incidentally, the scientific logic and scientific explanation matches with Advaita. Advaita was not an illogical thing. Okay? What is told as Maya in Advaita, I have brought in science and logic to explain to you.
Sir,
Anybody has a question?
So everything is happening by guidance, what we understood from your talk. But then we feel that I'm doing or my will is working. So even that feeling or thought has been given by guide.
Absolutely.
And guide will guide us.
Yes, you are right. A very, very good question. So I have a feeling that my will is there. Okay? Even though I know that reality is thy will, I have a feeling my will is there. That's also given by who? Thy will. So, the free will, you have a concept of free will, which you believe in reality. The free will guides you to become free from will. Mark my words. Can I repeat it? The free will, individual notions of free will, what you have, through lifetime guides you to make you understand and help you to become free from the will.
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, I'm just giving an analogy. So, you have seen the coconut, right? The coconut has a outer thick, what is it? Shell. Then inside is a hard kernel. Then inside the soft cobra, cobra is there, right? Which is real coconut? Ultimately, what is valuable to you or nature is the inside, what is the white thing. Outer layer is there, one or two layers are there, right? So that is there, why is there? As a protection for the inner, correct? And when that becomes redundant, when the coconut falls in the ground and starts sprouting, that shell will be broken and the sprouting happens. The shell will be no longer required. Understand? So the free will is like the outer shell which is given to you until you are really ready to become free from will.
It has a purpose.
The purpose is to forget yourself, the divine nature, and act in the society as if you have free will. Okay? Until you are ready to go back to the source. Until you are ready to become free from the will.
Okay.
Huh?
Somebody is giving us this I consciousness and somebody is taking it away. It's like a play.
There's no somebody.
Or
there's nobody, not even you. That's only God. The individual notion is again illusion. Any questions? Anybody else has a question?
You
have to. But I have a free will not to answer. Okay, thank you very much.
So whatever goes, just leave it to God and say in the morning.
No. See, the God will say do this also. You know that tea is made by God, okay?
Yeah.
But God will say make the tea, otherwise husband will shout at you because husband is also God.
Yeah. Can they say that?
No. Understand, live with the understanding. Everything is happening with the totality. Okay? Still continue to do your work. Because thoughts will come to do your work. You have to do. Only your attitude towards life changes. The suffering will go. No regrets. No suffering. Everything is a prasada or gift from God. Halaladra haku. Niraladra haku. Right? That's the meaning of that. Anything. Okay, but if you start accepting something and rejecting something, then you fall into karma. You can choose that also. Okay, you can say that everything is my will, there's no God, that is called God of thy will. That's also okay. But for everything, you are responsible for consequences. You will accept the consequences here also, but you will accept the consequences here also. What is the difference? Here you will accept crying. Here, except laughing. Alright? So, you accept life joyfully here. But whatever has to happen will have to happen because of the destiny which Ramana Maharshi has told. You don't have a choice.
Sir, if everything is God's will, why bad things, crying and all happen?
So, don't ask, what about the others I will tell later. Because this is about the individual. So what happens in the bad or crying? This is a part of the nature for you to teach. Okay? Rama is a great divine being.
right? Is he? He is such a great being. If Ravana is there, then Rama's name will be coming anywhere. What is Rama without Ravana? Okay, the positive and negative is a part of this divine play. Okay, so it is there for you to tune to which one you want. If negative is there, it is for you to tune to the positive and solve the negative. The God has given the opportunity. Tomorrow you can't blame God that you didn't give the opportunity. That's why good and bad is there. Are you clear? It's a part of the opportunity provided for you. Okay, now today last counting now. Exit polls are over. So how many people for Daivil?
Everybody, sir.
Okay, anybody left for free?
But that
Sanandar has to be real, right? So what topic, madam? Next two speakers, what they will speak on?
Yeah. Unfortunately, they didn't come and play.
Okay.
Sir, we need a series of topics to understand this also.
See, this is actually what is spirituality, right? Spirituality is not a sadhana. Spirituality is breaking our mental notions. Illusions, that's called spirituality. Spirituality, we think that sitting and meditation for hours together. No. Spirituality is not going to Himalayas. Spirituality is not going and doing some chanting. Spirituality is we have a wrong understanding of life. That wrong understanding has to be logically, analytically, scientifically, and based on scriptures has to be understood. That opens up our notions. That is called spirituality. Huh? This is called Dharma. Okay, thank you. So there's a sweep, okay? That's what is called a tsunami. Time will go.
Thanks. Who will thank whom? I don't know.
You can thank God.
So let us thank Daivil for manifesting through my will. So our pranams to Sri Prabhuji. It was like a true Upanishad class, actually. Wisdom brought out through questioning. Guru questioning, disciples, disciples questioning, Guru.
Upanishad teaching is Guru doesn't give gyan, okay? Guru only questions your understanding. And gradually guides you to see the truth yourself. Guru doesn't give any ready-made truth, it's truth, then it becomes a religion.
So I think seeds of inquiry are quite deeply planted today. Even as you walk out, you wonder who is walking. So let us also give Sri Prabhuji a Pushpa Vrishti clap. Who is giving the clap? So, next week, that is next Saturday, continuing the same series, despite what has happened today, the destiny is still working, Thy will is still working.
Okay.
So, Srimati Sharada Sridhar, founder of Pragya, I think yesterday she conducted meditation also here. So she will be speaking on the topic action plan and surrender. Action plan and surrender. And next Friday, meditation will be conducted here by Shri Kantraj. I think he has come several times also. From Sky Simplified Kundalini Yoga, 6:30 to 8 on Friday. But meditation and study circle, our sister forum in Jayanagar, 4th key block, SSM Army College. We have on Monday, that is March 13th, Swami Chidatmananda from Akshavidya Sevashram, who is a disciple of Swami Dayananda Saraswati, will be speaking on the topic Shri Hari Sharana Stotram. Shri Hari Sharana Stotram. So if you want, you have doubts about what is surrender, you can come on Monday, 6:30 to 8 at SSM Army College. And if you want to listen to Shri Prabhuji again, you have an opportunity on Tuesday, that is 14th, this coming Tuesday, at SSM Army College again. He will be speaking on the topic in Kannada, Vartamana Dalli Jeevisi. Live in the present.
Just one.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, before I conclude, I have one more question to ask. One more time, last time. Okay? How many people are for Daivil? Please raise your hands. Daivil? Okay? That is false. The my and Dai comes from the concept that there is something separate from God. You understand? The my and Dai is also notional. Because everything is God, where is the concept of my and Dai? That's only to lead you to the point that even my and thy is false. I have taken the my. Are you clear? Which one? Everybody is God, yeah. No. That's what we'll get. So, when we say my, that's a concept of individuality comes into picture. Because you can't think of my other than without the other. You can't think of thy other than me. Thy and me both are false because there's only God.
So far, you made everything clear. But with the last question, yes, sir, you lose everything.
You go with this confusion. This question is for you to think over.
Yes.